I'm back in London, and after 3 years, and I'm walking the streets of London between medical schools, knocking on doors, trying to get a job. And one day I'm in Oxford Street, and a hand falls on my shoulders, and this is Professor Gary. He was the professor that I originally went to work with in Dundee. Meanwhile, he had moved to Glasgow. And so he took me back to his hotel and had some tea. And anyway, he said, well, you know, I could give you a job in Glasgow, but how about the vet school? Now, this was now 1950. And after the war, the post-war government decided to nationalize all the vet schools. There was one, the Royal Dick at Edinburgh, which was part in the university sector. All the others were private companies. So Glasgow had a thing called the Glasgow Veterinary College, housed in an 1840s building in Buccleuch Street. And it was pretty well, it was a dump, put it that way. But the university took it over, they had to by law, they were told, take it over. And they didn't know what to do with the vet school. But they did a clever thing. They headhunted the most successful veterinarian in the west of Scotland, a man called William Wipers, Bill Wipers. And so he said, why don't you come and meet Wipers? So I went and met him. And he's a man I learned to love. He was like a dog with crystal gray hair, big eyebrows, sharp face, piercing eyes, and he could go right to the point, and he could obfuscate like nobody if he didn't want you to make a decision. He could talk and talk and talk. Anyway, he offered me a job. So I got the job at a very tender age of starting a new department of physiology from scratch. There was nothing there. So I built myself a workshop and got the labs going and so on. And gradually it filtered up to the university, which that there was some funny young guy down the vet school who seemed to have equipment and be able to do experiments and things. And so I suddenly found people knocking at my door. Two of them I eventually worked with, two Georges, George Smith. I beg your pardon, two Smiths, George Smith and Adam Smith.